Hey guys, welcome, welcome, welcome to my channel. Thank you for coming in to another Black History celebration. Tonight, we are going to honor the legacy of Henrietta Lacks. Henrietta Lacks. As you can see, I just come in from work, guys. Yes, but I had to upload a video tonight. I'm serious about this thing, guys. We got to get a video up every day. We have to get a video up every day. And today in Black History, we want to honor the legacy of Henrietta Lacks. I don't know if you know who Henrietta Lacks is. I'm going to give you a little bit of introduction about her. And then I want to show you a short movie about her. And then I'm going to ask you to please leave a comment. First of all, make sure that you like this video, subscribe to this channel, and then leave a comment if you knew about Henrietta Lacks, and if you know about her story, and if you know about what happened to her, and how important her life is, was, and is in the future to medicine. So let's get into it. The legacy of Henrietta Lacks. In 1951, a young mother of five named Henrietta Lacks, L-A-C-K-S, visited the Johns Hopkins Hospital complaining of vaginal bleeding. Now, ladies, seriously, upon examination, renowned gynecologist Dr. Howard Jones discovered a large malignant tumor on her cervix. At the time, the Johns Hopkins Hospital was one of only a few hospitals to treat poor African Americans, poor Black people. Okay? How many people fall into that category? How many people did back in the day, in the 1950s, right? As medical records show, Mrs. Lacks began undergoing radiation for her cervical cancer. This was the best medical treatment available at the time for this terrible disease. A sample of her cancer cells retrieved during a biopsy were sent to Dr. George Geyes, G-E-Y-apostrophe-S, nearby Tisha Lab. Now, again, how many of us have had this done, ladies? I personally have a testimony about actually having to have to go through this procedure myself. Thank God that times are better now, okay? It says here, because they do a biopsy for us. It says here, and I also worked in surgery, so I know exactly what happened. So it says here, for years, Dr. Geyes, I pray I'm pronouncing it correctly, a prominent cancer and virus researcher, had been collecting cells from all patients, regardless of their race or socioeconomic status, who came to Johns Hopkins Hospital with cervical cancer. Wherever they were, he was getting samples. But each sample quickly died in Dr. Gay's lab. What Dr. Gay would soon discover was that Mrs. Lacks' cells were unlike any other that he had ever seen. Where other cells would die, Mrs. Lacks' cells doubled every 20 to 24 hours. Now, that is absolutely amazing. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine what was going through his mind? What in the world have we ran into here? What have we found? I mean, what is this discovery? Today, these incredible cells, nicknamed HeLa cells, from the first two letters of her name, of her first and last name, okay, Henrietta Lacks, are used to study the effects of toxins, drugs, hormones, and viruses on the growth of cancer cells without experimenting on humans. So her cells are still being used today. What you need, there's a whole lot more to this story. Whole lot more, okay? They have been used to test the effects of radiation and poisons, to study the human genome, to learn more about how viruses work, and played a crucial role in the development of polio and COVID-19 vaccines right here now. Did you know that? Guys, did you know that? This will be a short video, a short Black History video. I just got in. I'm a little tired. Gonna go right in and fix some lunch, some dinner, and get ready. Gotta go right back to work tomorrow. But this was a critical. This came to me at work, and I thought, you know what? Tonight, I want to do a tribute to Henrietta Lacks. Although Mrs. Lacks ultimately passed away on October the 4th, 1951, at the age of 31, her cells continue to impact the world today. Although these were the first cells that could be easily shared and multiplied in a lab setting, Johns Hopkins has never sold or profited from the discovery or distribution of HeLa cells and does not own rights to HeLa cells line of the HeLa cell line. Rather, Johns Hopkins offered HeLa cells freely and widely for scientific research. Now he's offering this. Does she know about this? Do the family know about this? You went in for a procedure. They found something in you that is amazing and that can help other people. Do you know about it though? Okay. All right. Johns Hopkins applauds and regularly participates in efforts to raise awareness of the life and story of Henrietta Lacks. Having reviewed our interactions with the Henrietta Lacks and with the Lacks family over more than 50 years, we found that Johns Hopkins could have and should have done more, here we go, to inform and work with members of Henrietta Lacks' family out of respect for them, their privacy, and their personal interests. Though the collection and use of Henrietta Lacks' cells in research was an acceptable and legal practice in the 1950s, the laws protecting research subjects have evolved. We at Johns Hopkins have been supportive of legal changes since 1951 that protect research subjects, and we are compliant with these requirements, including those related to informed consent, Consent. Give you consent to use them. We are deeply committed to the ongoing efforts of our institution elsewhere to honor the contributions of Henrietta Lacks and to ensure the appropriate protection and care of the Lacks family medical information. Now they are. So now what I'm going to do is show you this short film is what is happening now with the Henrietta Lacks study and family.
Of the Henrietta Lacks story, are people asking questions? for people trying to understand the biology of human cells. It's there for bioethicists, for patients. This is why Johns Hopkins is committed to outreach and education for all the community.
It's a labor of love. We all feel like we're connected to this beautiful woman who we call the mother of medicine. It really makes you think about how powerful an impact one person unknowingly could make.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you all for coming to learn more about my great-grandmother and what her legacy has left for all of us here today. So over 60 years ago, my great-grandmother...
In my capacity as the Director of Outreach for the Institute for Clinical and Translational Research, I organized educational programs related to Henrietta Lacks. And the main focus is to increase awareness of Henrietta Lacks's impact on medicine and society, to gain a better understanding of the science behind HeLa cells, and also to create an open dialogue about the social issues that were occurring around the time in which Henrietta Lacks's cells were cultured.
I would say that Henrietta is probably, if not the most important, certainly one of the most important women in science and medicine. And we all learn and follow Henrietta Lacks' legacy as we contribute to research and medicine.
Henrietta Lacks was a 31-year-old woman admitted to Johns Hopkins in 1951 for the diagnosis and treatment of cervical cancer. Unfortunately, she had a very aggressive cancer, and within a year, she had died. As part of the care she received at Johns Hopkins, the cells from her cervix were brought into a laboratory and cultured and have become the first human living cell line, which has allowed us to learn remarkable things about how human cells function.
It was really, in my opinion, the launch pad. Probably the greatest discovery in biomedical research in the last half of the 20th century. It has led to numerous discoveries and development of technologies.
It provided the ability for us to understand how cells grow, how cells divide, whether cells can survive in extreme climates, going into outer space, how radiation damages cells. How we can produce lots of material to make things like vaccines, which is all part of what the HeLa cell has done for science and for the public.
Just the fact that, you know, 65 years later, a sample of our grandmother's cell still exists out in the world today is almost superhuman.
Our responsibility is to honor the legacy of Henrietta, to thank her family, and thank her posthumously each year, which is what we do. We have a Henrietta Lacks Memorial Lecture. I think last year we had 1,000 people attend. Each year we organize the Henrietta Lacks High School Symposium. We've partnered with the Henrietta Lacks Legacy Group, the Turner Station Conservation Teams, and other groups to form a book club that builds a bridge for people who live in this community and Hopkins researchers to get together and really talk about issues. We also have the microscope day in which we open up the laboratory of one of our colleagues, Jim Potter. They learn about the significance of her cells. The Johns Hopkins Urban Health Institute offers a $15,000 partnership grant to community-based organizations that partner with Johns Hopkins researchers to address health challenges that are impacting people who live in Baltimore. We also partner with Dunbar High School to offer the Henrietta Lacks Scholarship for individuals who are interested in pursuing careers in medicine. And that is really, to us, one of the ultimate ways of honoring Henrietta Lacks, is to increase the prevalence of individuals working in medicine who understand the unique challenges of the community.
This scholarship is way more than just academics, is me being a part of a legacy. It shows you that Henrietta Lacks, herself did more than help cure diseases. Her her sacrifice, it has given teenagers like me an opportunity to excel in their future.
Students are the next generation. They're the next generation of doctors, researchers, scientists. So to get them exposed to the story of Henrietta Lacks and see the mistakes that were made and how we are moving forward, possibilities are endless.
What was most interesting to me was what the providers were saying.
Collaboration between the community and academics is what medicine is supposed to be. We're not supposed to be an ivory tower. We are supposed to be working with the people we serve. And by reaching out to the community, we better understand them, their needs, and they understand what it takes for us.
At some point and some time in life, everybody's gonna get sick. Everybody's gonna suffer from some type of disease, some type of cancer, some type of dementia, any type of thing. So we need research to, you know, find cures, find medication, and find some kind of prevention. So I think it's very important research, and I think, you know, we need to do our part to get involved.
So again, I want to say thank you for helping us honor my great-grandmother, Henrietta Lacks, and what she...
Henrietta passed away, but yet she still lives on, and she's making a huge impact on society today.
So now, let's do a couple of questions about Henrietta Lacks. One question is, what was so special about Henrietta Lacks' cells? So as we saw in the video, and as we said in the introduction, the donation of Henrietta Lacks' cells began what was the first, for many years, the only human cell line able to reproduce indefinitely. Her cells, known as the HeLa cells for Henrietta Lacks, remain a remarkably durable and prolific line of cells used in research around the world. This one woman, Henrietta Lacks. Isn't that amazing? Another question. Since they use her cells, did the Lacks family win a lawsuit because they didn't have permission to do this? So let's see. Henrietta Lacks family, settles lawsuit with a biotech company that used her cells without consent on August 1st, 2023. So they did get a lawsuit settled after all those years. What disease did Henrietta Lacks have? What disease? Remember, cervical cancer. And back in the day, they didn't really have hardly any cure for that. And like they were saying, for poor people, if you were black people, you did, or poor people, and you didn't have insurance or whatever the case may be. So it says here in 1951, Henrietta Lacks, a 31-year-old African-American or black woman, went to Baltimore Johns Hopkins Hospital to be treated for cervical cancer. Some of her cancer cells began being used in research due to their unique ability to continuously grow and divide in the laboratory. All right. Are HeLa cells still alive? Some 70 years on, the cell line from the original HeLa cells is still proliferating. In that time, more than 11,000 research publications have involved HeLa cells. Guys, that's amazing. That's amazing. Are HeLa cells still dividing? Since HeLa cells, like other cell lines, are termed immortal because they can divide an unlimited number of times in a laboratory cell culture plate, as long as fundamental cell survival conditions are met. So they can just keep going if they're in the right environment. This is amazing. So we've already said that they're used today. They're continuously being used around the world. Somebody asked, are they being used today? How many of Henrietta Lacks's children are still alive? Because she was at family. Let's see. Lacks's only surviving child, Lawrence Lacks Sr., lives to see justice done. Grandson Alfred Lacks Carter Jr. said, now 86, he's 86 years old now, Lawrence Lacks was 16 when his mother died. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. How much does HeLa cells cost? Okay. One vial of HeLa cells, excuse me, didn't mean to interrupt the mic. It says here is $690 plus one free 8 gigabyte USB vial is $2,830. And oh, I don't know, it's expensive. It's expensive. All right. Let's look at this question. What blood type was Henrietta Lacks? To answer questions about the immortal life of Henrietta Lacks, please sign up. Okay, so you have to sign up. But she was RH. Let's see here now. At one point, they find her medical records from right before her daughter's birth. They do say she was RH positive. That's what they have so far. She was RH positive. Okay. Let's see if there's anything else we can share here. So we know how old she was. We know her age. All right. Henrietta, how old was Henrietta Lacks Sells now as of 2023? Henrietta Lacks cells known as the HeLa cells are over 70 years old as of 2023. We're in 2024 now. That's 71. These cells were obtained from Lacks cervical cancer tissue in 1951 and have since been replicating outside her body. As her family member said, she is living on. She is continuing to live on. That's amazing. Now, we know that we're going to have eternal life in Christ. Well, it looks like she started, man, because she's gone and her she's still living on. Her cells are still living on. That is amazing. A question here says, who made money from the HeLa cells? Fisher Scientific. The family of Henrietta Lacks has reached a settlement from Thermo Fisher Scientific, a science and technology services company that profited by selling Lacks cells. But the agreement is likely not the last and is already prompting debate over the use of human specimens in scientific research. So they were just using her, oh my gosh. The family knew not about it. They were just using it, man. They had found something and they was going on with that thing. Oh my, let's see if we can answer, at least try to find one more question. I'm looking for a good question here. Why do HeLa cells keep dividing? It says, like many other cancer cells, HeLa cells have an active version of telomerase during cell division, which copies telomeres over and over again. This prevents the incremental shortening of telomeres that is implicated in aging and eventual cell death. So they just keep growing. They keep growing. Guys, I don't know what you learned from this, but we are honoring the legacy. I am on my show, honoring the legacy of Henrietta Lacks, this awesome, dynamic woman. What a contribution to medicine she has done. Even though she had no knowledge that she was doing it, because they did not let her know. The family didn't know. Now they're saying, they're getting to the place now that you have to have consent. But as you heard in the video and you heard in the introduction, they were just, they found something and they were just going ahead on and using it. They were just using it. But her life was immortal. I want to say thank you, Henrietta Lacks. Thank you to the Henrietta Lacks family. I pray that you get everything that is due to you. I pray that everything that is due to you comes to you. Because, I'm thankful that, as we saw in the video, it's being taught on and on. Not only are your cells living on, but now your story, it is educating others now. They're learning from you, from your cells, from your contribution. Wow. Wow. That is outstanding. It says here, what is so important about HeLa cells and who is responsible for the discovery? Well, we've gone over that over and over and over. It says, among the important scientific discoveries of the last century was the first immortal human cell line known as HeLa. We talked about that. A remarkably durable and prolific line of cells obtained during the treatment of Henrietta's cancer by Johns Hopkins researcher Dr. George Gay in 1951. So we talked about that. Thank you to the Lacks family, and you can find many of them. There's Deborah Lacks, David Lacks, Elsie Lacks, Zakaria Bari, Lawrence Lacks, and David Lacks Jr., and I'm sure there's more. Thank you for what you are doing and for what you have done. We honor Henrietta Lacks. We honor her legacy. We honor her life. Guys, if you've heard about this, please leave a comment. If you have not heard about it, please leave a comment. If you have a question, we need to do more research, please leave a comment. This is very interesting. This is Black History Month. But this study goes on, not just Black History Week, not just Black History Month. This is history that affects the world. Look at this lady's life. She's gone, but look at her cells. They're all over the place. They're affecting cure from COVID-19, really? All over. What an amazing, 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 amazing. What an amazing story. And she knew nothing about it. That's even more amazing. And the family knew nothing. That's outstanding. That is really just outstanding, I'm telling you. It's almost mind-boggling, really. But then, is it really? Because when we read our history, how many, we don't know how many other people went in to get something done. You know, I mean, you study our history, you know how medicine was It wasn't always in our favor. That's why today some blacks are still skeptical about going to doctors and getting treatment because of things like that. But I want to say this. Thank you so much for coming. And we're going to see you right here with more videos like this. Right here at Queen Sing NLB. Make sure you like, make sure you share, make sure you subscribe. Support your girl, the encourager. We'll see you right here next time.